The Theory of Political Economy by William Stanley Jevons. Chapter 3. Theory of Utility. Part 5. Total Utility and Degree of Utility. We are now in a position to appreciate perfectly the difference between the total utility of any commodity and the degree of utility of the commodity at any point. There are, in fact, quantities of altogether different kinds, the first being represented by an area and the second by a line. We must consider how we may express these notions in appropriate mathematical language. Let X signify, as is usual in mathematical books, the quantity which varies independently, in the case, the whole quantity of commodity. Let U denote the whole utility proceeding from the consumption of X. Then U will be, as mathematicians say, a function of X. That is, it will vary in some continuous and regular, but probably unknown manner, when X is made to vary. Our great object at present, however, is to express the degree of utility. Mathematicians employ the sign delta, prefixed to a sign of quantity, such as X, to signify that a quantity of the same nature as X, but small in proportion to X, is taken into consideration. Thus, delta X means a small portion of X, and X plus delta X is therefore a quantity a little greater than X. Now, when X is a quantity of commodity, the utility of X plus delta X will be much more than that of X as a general rule. Let the whole utility of X plus delta X be denoted by U plus delta U. Then it is obvious that the increment of utility delta U belongs to the increment of commodity delta X. And if, for the sake of argument, we suppose the degree of utility uniform over the whole of delta X, which is nearly true owing to its smallness, we shall find the corresponding degree of utility by dividing delta U by delta X. We find these considerations fully illustrated by figure 4, in which OA represents X and AB is the degree of utility at the point A. Now, if we increase X by a small quantity, AA1, or delta X, the utility is increased by the small rectangle, ABB1A1, or delta U. And since a rectangle is the product of its sides, we find that the length of the line AB, the degree of utility, is represented by the fraction delta U over delta X. As already explained, however, the utility of a commodity may be considered to vary with perfect continuity, so that we commit a small error in assuming it to be uniform over the whole increment delta X. To avoid this, we must imagine delta X to be reduced to an infinitely small size, delta U, decreasing with it. The smaller the quantities are, the more nearly we shall have a correct expression for AB, the degree of utility at the point A. Thus, the limit of this fraction, delta U over delta X, or as it is commonly expressed, du over dx, is the degree of utility corresponding to the quantity of commodity X. The degree of utility is, in mathematical language, the differential coefficient of U considered as function of X, and will itself be another function of X. We shall seldom need to consider the degree of utility except as regards the last increment, which has been consumed, or which comes to the same thing, the next increment which is about to be consumed. I shall therefore commonly use the expression final degree of utility as meaning the degree of utility of the last addition or the next possible addition of a very small or infinitely small quantity to the existing stock. In ordinary circumstances, too, the final degree of utility will not be great compared with what it might be. Only in famine or other extreme circumstances do we approach the higher degrees of utility. Accordingly, we can often treat the lower portions of the curves of variation which concern ordinary commercial transactions, while we leave out of sight the portions beyond P or Q. It is also evident that we may know the degree of utility at any point while ignorant of the total utility, that is, the area of the whole curve. To be able to estimate the total enjoyment of a person would be an interesting thing, but it would not be really so important as to be able to estimate the additions and subtractions to his enjoyment, which circumstances occasion. In the same way, a very wealthy person may be quite unable to form any accurate statement of his aggregate wealth, but he may nevertheless have exact accounts of income and expenditure, that is, of additions and subtractions.